A happy hello to all my wonderful children out there. I know, my dear children, you're a little fed up of listening to a lot of do's and don'ts. Do this, don't do that. Don't step out and wear a mask. But children, it's very, very important for us to learn how to keep yourself safe. Okay? So sit back today while I narrate to you a story which is inspired from a Russian folktale. And the story is titled Kolobok. Now, what is Kolobok? Kolobok is nothing like, it's simply a small, sweet, round bun. The type you have with bread and jam, okay? So it so happened that once upon a time, there lived a grandma and a grandpa in the village. So one day, the grandpa was a little hungry and he told the grandmother, "Grandmother, go scrape in the flour tin and sweep in the wheat bin. Perhaps you will get enough flour to make me a kolobok." So the grandmother went off and she scraped around the flour tin and swept the bottom of the wheat bin and she got a couple of handfuls of flour. Now she mixed the flour with cream and shaped it into a kolobok, a nice round bun. Then she baked it in the oven and left it on the windowsill to cool. And the kolobok lay there for some time. And then, you know, like a naughty child, suddenly it got up and was restless. And it rolled down from the windowsill.
Where are you going?" said Grandma. "It's not safe to go out."
But the kolobok was not ready to listen. So it rolled down from the windowsill to the bench. From the bench to the floor. Across the floor to the door. It hopped over into the hall and rolled onto the porch. And from the porch into the garden and from the garden out through the gate. Further and further it went. La 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 la. So the kolobok rolled down the road and suddenly it met a rabbit. Now this rabbit happened to be a Gujarati rabbit. Fortunately, we still have quite a few forests left in Gujarat. I'm sure you've heard of the Gir National Park and Wildlife Sanctuary. So the rabbit came from somewhere there. So the rabbit turned around and told Kolobok, "Kolobok, Kolobok, I'll eat you now. Hutane khai jaish," he said in Gujarati.
Don't eat me, rabbit. I'll sing you a song. And this is how my song goes.
Twinkle, twinkle, bread and jam, just keep wondering who I am. I am Kolobok, a nice round bun, baked in the oven till I was done. I ran away from Grandpa and Grandma too. And I'm sure I'll have no trouble running away from you. Off it rolled so fast that the rabbit could only stare. The kolobok went down the road and then suddenly it met a wolf. Now this wolf was a Punjabi, you know. But children, in Punjab, we have very few forests left now. Because we have cut down on so many trees. So where do you think this wolf came from? It came from the zoo, the Chhatbir Zoo in Punjab. So the wolf pounced at Kolobok and said, "Kolobok, I will eat you now. Main tenu kha jaunga," he said in Punjabi.
Don't eat me. Don't eat me. I'll sing you a song," said Kolobok. And he sang, "I am Kolobok, a nice round bun, baked in the oven till I was done. I ran away from Grandpa and Grandma too. I ran away from the rabbit too. And I'm sure I'll have no trouble, dear wolf, running away from you." And it ran away fast. The wolf could only stare. The kolobok now went down the road
and suddenly he met a Himalayan black bear. Now this black bear was from the Sundarbans forest of West Bengal. Yeah, so you could say that the black bear was a Bengali.
Aha, Kolobok, said the black bear.
I'll eat you now. Ami tome khe felbo, he said in Bengali.
Don't eat me. Don't eat me, dear bear. I'll sing you a song.
And the song went like this. I am Kolobok, a nice round bun, baked in the oven till I was done. I ran away from Grandpa and Grandma too. I ran away from the rabbit and the grey wolf too. And I'm sure I'll have no trouble, bear, running away from you. And again it rolled down the road. Now the Kolobok rolled down the road and it met a fox. Now children, you know that the fox is a very clever animal and generally found in every forest. So let's see what the fox has to say.
Ah, Kolobok, Kolobok, where are you going?
Ah, I'm just rolling along the road.
Kolobok, Kolobok, sing me a song.
Oh, my song? You want to hear me sing a song?
Sure, sure. I'm Kolobok, a nice round bun, baked in the oven till I was done. I ran away from Grandpa and Grandma too. I ran away from the rabbit and the grey wolf too. I ran away from the big bear, and I'm sure I'll have no trouble, dear fox, running away from you.
But the fox said, oh, what a fine song, what a fine song. Don't run away. You know what? I'm rather hard of hearing. Kolobok, can you be kind enough to sit on my nose and sing me a song a little louder?
So the Kolobok got taken in. All right. He hopped onto the fox's nose and sang the song again. But the fox said,
Kolobok, can you be kind enough to sit on my tongue and sing your song just one more time?
The Kolobok got taken in again. He hopped onto the fox's tongue. And the minute he hopped onto the fox's tongue, mwah, snap! The fox gobbled it up. And that was the end of Kolobok, the tasty round bun. So you see, children, we need to be intelligent and keep ourselves safe. We must know how to keep ourselves safe. And I have no doubt at all that each one of you is going to be a smart Kolobok and not act like the silly Kolobok who got eaten up by the fox. Happy listening!